Hello, this is Mocha Product Manager Martin Brennand, and welcome to this overview of what's new in Mocha Pro 2025.5.
This release packs in a great bunch of new tools to help in multiple areas of your work, including new machine learning tools, updates to Matte Assist, more camera solve tools, and even more export options. A new addition to the track module is a section for detecting and quickly masking faces in your shot. Simply check the Generate Face Layers option in the Detect subtab, and then render forwards. Each face detected in the scene will then be tracked and added to a new faces group in the layer list. If a face is obscured for a moment, the track layer will hide and a new layer will begin when the face returns. Any false positives can easily be removed with a simple delete. Base layers are clipped to their visible range in the shot, making it easier to manage the layers over time, and exports have been updated to support this layer range where possible. Artists are saving huge amounts of time with Mocha Pro's recent Matte Assist ML tools, but like any new tool, improvements can be made. Alongside general speed improvements, we've now introduced the ability to edit problem Matte Assist ML frames. To use the tool, go to a problem matte frame in your shot and click Reference from Matte, which will pop out an exact spline replica of your matte shape. You can then make any adjustments to the frame you need, including adding or removing points as necessary. At this point, you can choose to render the Matte Assist ML frames again using the new reference frame, or press the Matte from Reference button to convert your edits back to a matte frame. This makes cleaning up problem areas a lot simpler without having to keep re-rendering your mats. You can now also go straight from an object brush mask to rendering Matte Assist ML, skipping past finishing the spline. While we don't recommend this workflow for detailed matte work, it reduces the number of steps needed when a basic garbage mask will do. And speaking of simplifying, there is also a new Essentials workspace to make it easier to work with Matte Assist ML tools, with the classic tracking layout in one tab and the masking tools in the other. We've expanded the export dialog even further in this release with the option to add presets and batches of exports. Presets allow you to define your favorite options for any export and save them as a unique export type. This includes the new option to export specific named layers, which is especially helpful for projects where you often have the same subject matter or naming convention. You can now also add any export or preset to a queue of exports to batch out individual files to disk. Both presets and batches are stored in an editable JSON format, making it easier to manage file pipelines in your studio. CameraSolve has added more options for addressing moving objects. You can now solve for locked-off scenes, so moving objects can be solved directly. This provides more accurate moving object solves, as you no longer need points to solve for the stationary camera. You can also now snap imported USD models to moving objects to make it easier to visualize motion in the scene. Simply select your imported model, click Snap To, and then select a vertex on the solved moving object. The model will then be parented to the solved object and move with it. Snapped models are exportable with the data, either as a reference null object or the model itself, depending on the export type. Alongside these major updates, there have been a huge range of minor updates to improve day-to-day work. The new back and forth button means you can now track or render forward from any point to the end of your timeline, and Mocha will then immediately jump back to the starting point and render backwards, saving you time clicking around the interface. Fusion multi-poly exports now support Mocha layer names and blend settings for better one-to-one data match. SynthEyes files are now exported with all the 3D changes from Mocha and 2D trackers intact, making it easier to extend your 3D work across applications. And OCIO support has also been updated, now supporting ASUS 2.0. This, plus a large chunk of defect fixes and under-the-hood improvements, makes Mocha Pro 2025.5 a hefty update for all users.
We have a range of focused overviews and tutorials for you to get up and running with the latest updates. If you want to find out more about Mocha Pro 2025.5 and the full range of features, go check out the website at borisfx.com.